Although this film deals mainly with the competition, it also covers the car journey to and from the venue. And here we are, just loading the car up on the morning of departure. Waiting to board the boat from Dover to Calais. Journey, we had to cross three ferries. This particular one was between Germany and Denmark. Thank you. we coasted into Helsingborg Harbour, we were nearing the end of our journey, and finally, after 960 miles, we arrived at our destination. See Ralph Brook, the eventual winner of the competition, just turning up his Merco 61. Here you see Cliff Wirick of America, starting the engine on his Candy. This was a prototype Vico 61. Here comes Corgi of Italy for a landing. And here you see Zell Ritchie, also of America, making minor aileron adjustments. Here you see Bosch's crash model, which he crashed during practice. And you can see a styrofoam wing. Here you see the American team in practice. There goes Zell Ritchie's model, followed by Ralph Brooks' Crusader, which is followed by Cliff Wirick's Candy. And here you see them landing in the same order. Shot of the Swedish models. And here you see England's own Pete Waters making trim adjustments to his Altair. These shots were taken inside the hangar. Here we have the Japanese team, both the identical models. And here comes the other one landing. Here you see Ron Chapman's Norseman 4. This model featured retractable undercarriage. And there you see the new Canadian proportional, which most of, well, two of the Canadians were using. And there you see a detailed shot of Ron Chapman's undercarriage. And here he goes on a takeoff. Of the living quarters, which was actually a converted monastery. Here we see Ralph Brook again, testing his Merco 61, which he actually borrowed for this competition. Here goes the Italian team.
which is model of Germany, the Dolphin just taking off. This was his second model, as you saw he prang the first one in practice. Second competition flight. See myself again on the transmitter, just recovering from a spin there, and here comes a landing approach.
number 32, Great Britain, prepare for relevox.
Place man Chris Tewin from Belgium.
Here you see a shot of DeBolt's magnetic brake, which works off a single pen cell. These shots were taken during a dinner break on the last day, which the Americans were showing us how to do a pylon racing. They ended up pranging two models and dinting the other one. Here's the first one, which overrolled at a pylon. Quite disastrous. Sticking up in the grass is Ralph Brooks' second model, which an elevator linkage came undone. Go up there. And here we are on the morning of departure, just packing the car up, ready to leave. Ended the 1965 World Radio Control Championships. The eventual team placings were USA first, Great Britain second, and Canada third. Although the British team were flying with Reeds, 90% of all the equipment used was of the proportional type, so it would seem inevitable that if we are to do any good at the next World Championships, we most certainly will have to be using proportional equipment. All that remains now is the return journey. Originally, when this film was taken, it wasn't known that sound would be added, but I hope that it has given you some idea of what went on at the World Championships.